Hello and welcome to the show. It's Sports Clinic on Unilag TV. And I'm your host, Victor Adeomi. As you have come to expect, I have Shane Wajidagba with me in the studio. Shane, welcome to the show once again.
It's a pleasure to be here.
The show promises to be an exciting one, I hope.
Definitely.
All right. Now, in case you're not aware, we are just under a month to the start of the African Cup of Nations qualifiers, and the game between Nigeria and South Africa is going to be paramount on our discussion today. In preparation for that game, a list has been released by Gennet Trauer, and that list is creating a whole lot of controversy. We'll be looking at the controversy that this list is creating, and we'll be looking at how it will if it will affect the performance of the team in that game. But first, we'll be looking at the return of Mara Sharapova. She's back to tennis, and she's playing in the Madrid Open. And then we'll also be looking at what next for world champion Anthony Joshua. We want a quick break. When we come back from the break, the show starts in earnest. Glad to have you back. Quickly to Mara Sharapova. Mara Sharapova is back. She's back with the Madrid Open. We know she was playing the Porsche tournament earlier. Now, this is the second tournament after her return from her 50-month ban. Sharapova is out of the Madrid Open again. This time, at the hands of the person that called her a cheat. What's up with that? Come on.
Well, for Sharapova, remember she got a 15-month suspended ban.
Yes.
She was supposed to get a 2-year ban for using meldonium, who was a banned substance, but it was reduced to 15 months. And that generated a whole lot of controversy because Porsche tournament had started some 2 days before she returned,
but she still
took part in that tournament, got knocked out in the semi-final. This Madrid Open, it caused a whole lot of controversy again because they gave her a wild card to be part of that tournament. But prior to her game against Eugenie Bouchard, the Canadian lady who was her conqueror, the lady used to adore Mara Sharapova because she's a 5-time Grand Slam winner. No doubt, one of the biggest female tennis in terms of endorsement before she was overtaken by Serena Williams. Mm-hmm. But prior to that duel, she called her a cheat. Because what she saw was, even if you're going to give her a suspended sentence, she was not supposed to come back for that Porsche tournament. A lot of people, you know, raised eyebrow about the Porsche tournament, but they said because Porsche was part of the sponsor of Mara Sharapova. But at the end of the day, she fought her way, knocked out Mara Sharapova, even went ahead to knock out a certain Angelique Kerber, because Kerber had to retire against Eugenie Bouchard.
She was already 5-0.
She won the first set 6-3, won the second set 5-0, before Kerber retired injured. Kerber has been having a whole lot of injuries in 2017, since she became world number one. Yes, that position was overtaken by a certain Serena Williams, but because Serena Williams will not be taking part in any tournament for the whole year, owing to pregnancy, she will return to world number one when the new rankings are released next week. But the challenge is, we have not seen much of Angelique Kerber, the supposed world number one.
All right. The male version, Wawrinka, is also out of the Madrid Open as well. Why is it that, although most of the champions are still there, we still have Nadal,
we have Djokovic, and we have
the tournament is still pretty exciting.
Yeah, it's still exciting. You know, Wawrinka, like we always say,
yeah,
a game that he wants to play with his heart of heart, he will beat anybody in the world.
Yeah.
But sometimes he does things that you get stunned, and that's the world of tennis. He was beaten by a certain Bernard Pearl. But to know that you have the defending champion in a certain Novak Djokovic, who parted ways with all his backroom staff, so he's going to this tournament
refreshed and new.
Let me use the local parlance. Now let me waka come.
Okay.
But he said before the French Open starts on the 28th.
He will announce
his new coach.
Yeah.
But we still have Rafael Nadal, the man who did well. You know, we still have Andy Murray, who is still trying to fight his way back. We still have the likes of Nick Kyrgios. We have all the guys. So what I'm saying is, the tournament is still getting exciting.
Right.
And then the odds favor a certain Rafael Nadal.
Let's quickly switch tournaments now. To the NBA playoffs. Houston Rockets, they are losing 3-2, they are losing to San Antonio Spurs, and they are going to the last game, knowing that they have to win that game to still stand a chance. What do you think that's going to happen?
These records need to show that what they did to the team, Houston Rockets, remember the last time out, they beat the team of Russell Westbrook, Oklahoma City Thunder. They taught them a basketball lesson. But they are facing a San Antonio Spurs who has got experience in their manager and some of their players. Like we always say, what their legs cannot do, they do in what we call pick and roll. Pick and roll is a style that is adopted by their coach and a very experienced coach in Greg Popovich. Now, they are leading them. they need to fight back.
They need to fight back.
And in fighting back, the support cast of James Harden needs to come to the party. And then the likes of
leave him to do everything.
The likes of Beverly, Ndumbe, all of them must come and show that they need to support James Harden.
So now they have to fight to push this game to Game 7.
They have to fight to push this game to Game 7.
Not,
because we know that for the Spurs, we have the experienced guys, the Tony Parker, we still have the LaMarcus Aldridge. Yeah, Kawhi Leonard might be a bit having an injury in his ankle. They still got the big guys. I mean, that can get them the victory.
Can get them through.
So I see a San Antonio Spurs with experience getting the better of.
They already have the advantage, so it won't be too much of a surprise. Waiting for San Antonio Spurs will be the Golden State Warriors.
Yeah.
So it's going to, well rested, to be a very.
They thought Utah.
4-0. They didn't even have to.
It was a sweep. So a lot of people are saying what we saw the last time out, we're going to see a repeat of it. I mean, Golden State Warriors and Cleveland Cavaliers playing in the final of the NBA playoffs. But remember that it's not LeBron James did what nobody had ever achieved in the history of basketball, coming from three down to still win the series. Because at one point in time they were trailing 3-1, but they now won three straight games to win 4-3.
Thumbs up to LeBron. On the other side, Boston Celtics versus Washington Wizards. It's 3-2 to Boston Celtics. Another game where they need, where
I see Boston Celtics pulling through to the final. They've got some decent players. Isaiah Thomas, I told you about Isaiah Thomas, despite all the troubles he went through. I remember that when the regular season ended, it was Boston Celtics that won the regular season. Cleveland Cavaliers finished in second position. So I like to see number one take on number two.
Cleveland Cavaliers is waiting for them as
Yes, they are waiting for them.
So whoever wins this game goes to face Cleveland Cavaliers.
Yes.
It's also going to be a game of sevens, I think.
Yeah, it's best of seven.
All right. Quickly to the Rugby World Cup. You have details of that.
The draws have been. But what interested me the most is the Three Lions. They call them the English national team. They have a new manager.
I'm not talking about the defending champions.
New Zealand, because we know they always do well.
And then, so why do you think England will come to the?
Why I'm talking about England is because they now have a new manager.
Okay.
He used to be the coach of Japan.
His pedigree?
Eddie Jones, fantastic manager. Even Antonio Conte went to see Eddie Jones to tell him some of the tricks he's using to transform the English rugby team. I mean, the same Antonio Conte, the coach of Chelsea. He's a fantastic manager. He was once with the Japanese the last time out. Coincidentally, Japan was the World Cup, but it's going to be in 2019.
Yeah.
And he joked about it.
Why are they doing the draws this early?
For you to know that the World Cup is coming anytime soon.
Okay.
Before you open and close your eyes, before you see Jack Robinson, the World Cup is staring us in the face. So what he's just trying to do, the draws have been held. They are in a relatively difficult group. Argentina, France, and two other qualifiers that will join up with them.
Yeah.
But what I'm talking about Eddie Jones is he's done great things for the English rugby team. He's former coach of Japan, and he said he's even going to go to Japan to go and do some prayer so that the team can do well. Japan at the last World Cup did very well, not because they got anywhere, but they stunned one of the teams that we always look at, which is South African team. And then it was Eddie Jones that was coaching them. So I'm watching out for the World Cup.
From our perspective here, we don't really play rugby, so it's not going to be.
We play rugby in Nigeria, but we are not on that same level.
No.
But watch out for New Zealand. I love to. They call them the All Blacks.
Yeah.
That haka thing that they do.
Yeah.
You know, that haka thing is more like a swag.
I really like it.
To intimidate your opponent. And then
they actually even intimidate viewers. Not talk about.
Yes, and you know the final then was the New Zealand against Australia.
Yeah.
They call Australia the Wallabies.
Yeah.
So we are waiting for another interesting World Cup in 2019.
Alright. Finally to Anthony Joshua. Now, a lot of media razzmatazz is about what next for Anthony Joshua. What next? Well, let me start with this. There's a Ghanaian boxer, a Ghanaian champion. What's his name? Kamoko. He says he will beat Joshua. He says he will beat Tyson Fury. Should Joshua even consider the guy?
He's looking for cheap publicity.
But then if you see the guy well,
Victor,
let's give it
looking for cheap publicity.
Looking for cheap publicity.
We are not going to give
everybody wants to fight Anthony.
He should first go to the Olympics and first win an Olympic gold medal.
Okay, but talking about Joshua, what next for Joshua now?
There are so many people that have been lined up according to Eddie Hearn. After beating Klitschko, remember Klitschko said he wants a rematch, that in their contract there was a rematch but we are still waiting for that.
Whatever is going to happen now is not going to be maybe the same.
We are looking at Luis Ortiz, We are looking at Deontay Wilder. Mm-hmm. We are looking at Joseph Parker. Mm-hmm. We are looking at
the New Zealand guy. That's
yeah, Parker. Joseph Parker. Yeah. We are looking at Luis Ortiz. We are looking at Deontay Wilder. There's also Tyson Fury somewhere. But the, according to the report,
yeah.
at the end said there is a bout that have been agreed for April next year between Tyson Fury and.
But is it not too early to start believing these reports? Because a lot of things,
No. Because they need to plan. They need to start planning.
Exactly.
And that's why they said something next year. But the conundrum for Tyson Fury is he needs to get his license back. Mm-hmm. His license was revoked because of drug-related issues.
Yes.
So once he gets his license back, then he can start talking about when he's coming back. But he has started talking, doing all the trash talk. Remember when AJ defeated Klitschko?
Yeah.
He called him out and said, "Cry baby, come out now and come and fight me." But he has also responded, "I accept your fight." I mean, Fury talking about it, said, "Me, I'm not 41 years old. I'm a young boy. I will fight you with one hand tied at my back, and I'll beat you and beat you very well." But it's an unfolding story. Another part I'm watching out
exactly,
for.
Exactly, the Alvarez fight.
Triple G, they call him Gennady Golovkin.
Yeah.
Against Sal Canelo Alvarez. Alvarez has more fights than Gennady Golovkin. But the difference between the two is where a certain Gennady Golovkin that we call Triple G is yet to be undefeated. He has just lost one bout, but he has experience. That bout is in sometime September 16 to be precise. I cannot wait for those
but
guys.
But from the perspective of publicity, the fight is not really generating.
Ah, don't worry. These are two guys that can box to save their life.
All right.
They can box. As in,
at what point are we going to see them fight Joshua?
They're still in the
different category.
They are in the different
category. The lightweight category.
They're not in the heavyweight. So you not say, but in that they are weight category. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They are in the same weight category with the likes of Manny Pacquiao and Floyd Mayweather Jr.
All right.
So we are watching out for that bout, September 16. Keep that date in your diary.
All right, that way. And we hope that you also will keep that date, September 16. Let's go on a quick break, shall we? When we come back from this break, we'll really go to the home front. The controversy we talked about earlier, we're going to go into more details about that. And then, of course, the Confederations Cup, Rivers United, they're going to be on the continent this weekend. We'll talk about it when we come back from this break. Welcome back from the break. We go quickly to the issue of the Super Eagles and the list. Sheo, the list has been released. And we know that they invited three home-based players. Stephen Odi, of course, that's inevitable. And Olatunbosun. And the other guy from
Azam Ibrahim.
Yeah, from Akwa United.
Yeah, we say Muazzam.
Yeah, exactly.
In actual fact, there are four home-based players.
Okay.
Let's not get this thing muddled up.
Okay.
The media officer of the Super Eagles, Tony Bitoye, said this list is released for the game against Corsica, island in France. Where we'll be camped prior to coming to Nigeria to face the South Africans on June 10. This will be used as a friendly game to test run some players.
After this game,
they will even release some money.
Okay.
Because a lot of people are looking at this.
So are they looking to invite more players after the game against Corsica?
Yes.
Okay.
You don't have Victor Moses on this list.
True. Yeah.
There's no John Obi Mikel on this list, the captain of the side. Yes, he's just recuperating.
Yeah.
There is no Ogenyo Nazi.
Mm-hmm.
The China people are not there. So we are waiting for Gennaroa to give us a comprehensive list when we are going
then
to play.
The question now is, why is it generating so much controversy if this list is not the final?
Yes, I'm starting the controversy.
All right, good.
Invitation to national team should be meritorious.
Oh, you have an issue with names,
yes.
Names of people on the
list? Ikechukwu is the one that has always been bandied to be in goal for us.
Mm-hmm.
For the life of my money, he's not the best goalkeeper in Nigerian Professional Football League. I have names of goalkeepers that are better than Ikechukwu Ezenwa. Theophilus Afelohai is a better goalkeeper. Olufemi Thomas is a better goalkeeper.
So are we questioning the knowledge or the integrity of the NFF Technical Committee?
He has Salisu Yusuf as assistant.
Yes.
Who should be keeping an eye on keepers who are doing well week in, week out in Nigerian Professional Football League. So now, I think that was enough. Ederson Echejile, I keep asking a question. Somebody that cannot defend to save his life. He's the left back of the Super Eagles. He left Monaco, went to Sporting Hyon. In Sporting Hyon, that's a relegation bound team.
Yeah.
He has just played three games.
In the whole season.
And the same player.
When did he go to Sporting? Was it at the beginning of the season?
He went on loan to Sporting Hyon.
In general.
Because he could not get a playing time in Monaco.
Yeah.
The same player he's still playing for us. Are we saying we don't have better left back in the Nigerian professional football league?
You know, we've always, questioned.
Olai, you know, who we are told that after the FA Cup final is when he will join up.
Yes, yeah.
The likes of Iwobi and Moses.
Yeah.
Olai, you know, will not be on the bench. I can bet all my salary and every of my property
in Chelsea.
In the FA Cup final. Mm. We know those who are going to be on the bench. We know the likes of John Terry will be on the bench.
True.
Cause Zuma will be on the bench.
Yeah.
Ruben Loftus-Cheek.
William will be there.
Yeah. Aspen Begovic.
There are bigger players.
And you have only seven players to be on the bench.
How many players has he even played for?
Play for what?
He has not played for Chelsea this season.
The last time he played was in the FA Cup.
Yeah, the FA Cup.
The Capital One Cup.
Sorry, Capital One Cup.
So yeah. he will not get to play. And these are players that have been invited. Now, the list is generating.
Iwobi is another question. He's been out of the Arsenal team.
We know what Iwobi can offer.
But the
technical committee of the Nigeria Football Federation are complaining. Mm-hmm. A member of them is saying that Gerard Roy is not carrying them along.
Yeah.
By bringing the list. That the issue of Tyrone Obeyi is another issue that the T's have not been crossed, the I's have not been dotted. They are also talking about inviting players that they think should not get into the national team. But they said they don't want any controversy because a lot of people now say the technical committee are interfering with what the coach is doing.
Yeah.
But truth be told, the technical committee and the coach must have a synergy. They must have what we call a symbiotic relationship. And Demola Alajire, the director of competition, the director of media in Nigeria Football Federation, has said the supposed friendly match that we said wanted to play against Germany in November is not
feasible.
It's not feasible because these people plan long term.
True.
And there is no way they can accommodate us. And say that November is the period where we'll be playing the the Algerians in a World Cup qualifier. And before them, we cannot start playing some friendly games. That is not feasible and it's not possible. Yeah. We wait to see what happens, but we are waiting for the game against South Africa. They have a new coach in Stuart Baxter. He wants to come here and come and beat us, just like they did in 2015.
And they've not really beaten us in the competitive from
qualifying. Yes, so they debarred us from qualifying for the Nations Cup in 2015.
We played the draw.
So I hope Gennaro will continue in this step because he has not drawn any competitive games.
Let's still stay with Nigeria and quickly to the club aspect now, the CAF Confederations Cup. Rivers United, they are claiming that they are prepared because, you know, they just concluded the state FA Cup, the Confederations Cup in the state levels, and Rivers United are claiming that they are ready to go to Tunisia.
Victor, let's not sweat away. I wish them all the best. I hope they can replicate what happened against Real Bamako. That was the only period they got
An away draw.
This will be very difficult because Far Rabat of Morocco is an experienced side on the continent.
Is it Far Rabat or Club African?
They have Far Rabat of Morocco first. Yeah. They have Club African in their group, and they have KCCA of Uganda. Yeah. These are people who are experienced. You can only say KCCA, but for KCCA to be in their hearts, it means they have done credibly well to be deserving of playing in the Confederations Cup.
Yeah.
I wish Rivers United all the best. They've got some decent players. Unzube, Anazemba, Olufemi, Thomas, Sunday Rotimi, Guy Kuman, Esosai Binoba. You know, they've got some quality players.
Yeah.
Can that quality be translated on the continent? Mm. That remains to be seen. But I have a doubt because they are going to the North African teams who can be very tricky.
We just have to wish them all the best.
Definitely.
All right. We'll go on a quick break. When we come back from the break, we now know the finalists for the UEFA Champions League, and of course we know that the race for the Champions League the top four race, we talk about it. I know we are both, of course we know what happened the last time we met, so we'll talk we'll go into more details when we come back from this break. Welcome back to the show. Sean, we'll quickly talk about what happened in the UEFA Champions League. We now know the finalists. After the first leg, we knew that it was already tilting to the favourites, Juventus and Real Madrid. And now it was confirmed Juventus are through to the Champions League final. Real Madrid are through. It's going to be an epic game, an epic showdown in Cardiff. That's going to be on June 3rd. That game is now creating, of course, between us, we already know the controversy. You are pro Madrid, I'm pro Juventus. But what was true? What happened in the semifinals?
The semifinal got ended in the first leg. When you go to principality,
I thought so.
When you go to the principality,
yeah,
to get a 2-0 result and Monaco not scoring at all. And then you are now talking about a team that was yet to concede in some 698 minutes. Yeah. You want to say that they are vastly experienced. Mm-hmm. Where you have Bologna, Cellini.
But the other game was almost tilted, almost caused, because first 15 minutes 2-0, and then we're expecting game on. Of course, it was game on, and then of course we know what happened.
Like I made mention in the principality, the first leg had ended. Immediately, Iguain scored those two goals.
No, I'm afraid you're talking about the
match. Yeah, I want us to just
finish.
The first leg ended once they failed to score.
Mm-hmm.
Monaco, and we knew that they were coming to face a Juventus side that was very stingy in defense. So the tie had already ended from the first leg, and they completed the job in the second leg. But big credit has to go to Daniel Alves, a man that we thought his career was over. Three assists and one goal.
Yeah.
What more can you say? Incredible and fantastic performance. We have to give credit to Mbappe also, young man who also
broke the chain.
Yes, scored against Buffon. As at the time Buffon was doing his thing, this young boy was not born.
Buffon, the images I'm seeing, Buffon just absolutely loves.
He loves Mbappe. He loves Mbappe.
Yeah.
Fantastic, but you have to give credit to Leon Desjardins and Monaco. They live with their health. Real Madrid against Atletico.
That
ended in the first leg.
Was supposed to end in the first leg.
Yeah, but immediately we saw the fight back. Yeah, but you always know that Real Madrid will always get a goal.
I didn't always know because
defensively, we know they are frail. But going forward, they are arguably one of the, and they set a record also one of the teams that will always score in, they equal the record of Bayern Munich.
Yeah, so
we knew they will always score.
Mm-hmm.
And the Atletico Madrid will always concede. So we are setting up for a tantalizing final. Real Madrid against Juventus in Cardiff. I like to see the reunion. I'm saying that Zidane will be facing his former club, Juventus. Kedira will be facing his former club, Real Madrid. Morata will be facing his former club,
Juventus.
Hey, and then I'm looking out for those wonderful and interesting.
I just hope Buffon can.
And Iguain too can also
Champions
be.
League
Iguain will also be facing his former club.
True.
And we are looking out for Buffon. The only title that has eluded him.
We'll
see what happens, but watch out for that day, June 3rd. And maybe a quick one on the league, the way it's going.
Yes.
Chelsea is their title to lose. They'll win it.
7 points ahead.
They'll win it. There's nothing Tottenham can do anymore.
Although this game against West Brom, it's usually dicey for Chelsea, but regardless.
Chelsea will do everything.
Because Tottenham are.
The one everybody's talking about is the top four. That is still up for grabs.
That is the most exciting part of the
season. There's Liverpool in it.
Mm-hmm.
There's Tottenham in it. There's Arsenal in it.
There's United in it.
United has a slim chance. You know, I told you about Manchester City.
Yeah.
So, whoever will get it, we will get to know this weekend because they've got some.
Yeah. Let me quickly read out the games. Chelsea are going away to the Hawthorns to play West Brom.
They'll get to win that one.
West Ham are going to be hosting Liverpool. Yes. That's the big game.
No, West Ham is hosting Liverpool.
Yes. That's the big one.
They have to be very careful.
Manchester City will play Leicester City.
Yes.
Anything will happen in that game.
And Stoke and the retainer against Arsenal.
And then, of course, United are going away to White Hart Lane. That's going to be their final home game of the season.
Yes.
And then we know that these games are pretty exciting.
Pretty exciting.
It's going to shape how the season
will be. But in La Liga, I'm looking at that one. This weekend is also a very integral weekend for Real Madrid. They will be facing Sevilla.
Sevilla have not been the best
of Sevilla that we know.
Let's
so, Ogier Sampaoli would like to rally his troops in ensuring that they cause problems for Real Madrid. But I think Real Madrid quality will see them through. The World Cup in 2026, week one, they had a meeting in Bahrain, and it was agreed in January that they should increase 32 to 48 teams.
Yeah.
What I'm talking about is this. Africa, as against five that we're getting,
we
have been giving nine, and it could
extend to a playoff place now,
which is 10.
9.5.
So,
if you don't qualify,
32 increase to 48, but that will happen in 2026.
Yeah.
That is the faith that Gianni Infantino is reposing on Africa, who ensured that he got that seat. And I like what he's doing. He's also looking at the case we talked about, the mortality.
Yes, I wanted us to understand that.
He will meet with the FA.
I would like to give them credit for overturning the yellow card. So Mudari is free to play, and then with the support he's getting, so it's like
it's fantastic.
Kick out racism.
Yes, we need to stamp it out and stamp it out very, very well.
Final words, Shane. It's been an exciting show.
Yeah.
So your final words.
My final words. Go there, enjoy the best of football, and hoping that we do the build up and the countdown to the big one.
Yeah. From the next edition of the show is going to be a little bit more fiery and exciting. All this, our cool talk about Anthony Joshua, is going to be a little bit more.
I hope the studio will be able to contain it.
Hope you are going to be ready.
The studio will
you won't come here and talk. I'm talking like show on.
Just like R. Kelly does.
Yeah.
Burn it up.
Mm. I'll be ready for you.
On fire.
I'll be ready for you.
Okay.
And then whoever is going to join us on the show will also be ready for
you. Yes.
It's been an exciting one. We hope that you go out there and enjoy your weekend, enjoy the best of football, and hope that Arsenal defeats Stoke. Hope that United lose to Tottenham. And then you guys, hope your teams also win. All right. Have a great day, guys.